friends, namaste, this is Nehal, and once again you are most welcome to crazyforveggie.com. Now today I'm going to make a traditional dessert, Indian dessert, that is called Gajar Ka Halwa. And this is so yummy and delicious, and it's like little bit time consuming but very easy to make. So for that we need ghee, which I already added in my pan. And into that, I'm going to add this shredded carrot. This is a 2 lb shredded carrot, which I'm going to add into my ghee. Okay, so now as I everything added, now I'm going to just mix it well with the ghee. Keep your flame on medium for now and mix everything well. Now see, this is not a dish for a person who are calorie conscious or, you know, like who are so health conscious, because this dish is full of calories and richness. And you know, I don't want to cook this dish in a pressure cooker or in a, you know, like short and in a sweet method. I want it to be in a traditional way, because it will have a lot of flavor if you are going to make it in a traditional way, like cook it in a pan rather than pressure cooker. So definitely I will follow the traditional recipe only. Wow, the smell of ghee is just yummy, you know, delicious. And now I coat this shredded carrot with a ghee, and now I'm going to keep my flame little bit lower, not exactly on a low but between medium to low. Okay, and now I'm going to cover it, and we have to let it cook for next 5 minutes. So friends, it's been 5 minutes now, and now again we have to give a quick stir to it. Okay, and wow, now you know, like you can see that its quantity is becoming less because our carrot is started to cook, and that's why is, you know, become more thinner and softer. So now at this point, keep your flame on like between medium to high for a temporary basis, because I'm going to add milk into it, that's why. So 1 cup, 2 cups, and let me see first. Now see, you can add khoya, mawa into it if you wish, but I don't want to add mawa because I don't know, somehow I don't like to add mawa. I have it in my freezer but I don't want to add. I will going to add milk. So if you are not going to add khoya, then definitely you will need like quite more amount of ghee, quite more amount of milk. So this is a 2 cup, and I still need 2 more cups into it. Okay, one more and yet another more. Okay, so it's been 4 cups of milk. Now see, we have to cook our this halwa in milk. Okay, so it will have a taste of milk and it will cook with milk, so it will give like different kick, you know. Even though like if you are adding the khoya, that will be the same result, but I like milk best and little bit, you know, less calorie, even though I don't count calorie in this recipe. But okay, so now as I mix it, once I have to, you know, I will wait until it starts to bubbling. It's like it's almost already start to bubbling now, so that's okay. Now I'm going to cover it and wait for like, you know, 5 minutes. Keep your flame between medium to low. And so now our carrots been cooking since 10 minutes, and you know, because of we have added milk into it, you can see that it's start to create a foam and it will come on the top on your lid. So when it's going to happen, you know, just open your lid little bit so the foam will, you know, just set into the bottom, and then again cover it. So cook like that for like 10 minutes. And now as our carrots are cooked, now I'm going to take this lid out. And now we are going to cook it open. Now see, we have to burn this milk. We have to cook our carrot in milk. So that's why we have to cook until, you know, the mix is milk is totally burned, evaporated. So now I'm going to keep my flame little bit on like medium. Okay, and now we have to cook it, because now we can raise little bit heat, because now we are not covering it, so we don't have to, you know, bother about if milk will come out or not. So that's fine. And now cook until, you know, all the milk is just evaporated, and then we'll follow the next step. It's been now half an hour since our, you know, halwa is cooking. And you can see that milk is evaporated quite well, almost like more than 95%. And now into that, I'm going to add my sweetened condensed milk. And you can even, you know, add a sugar if you want. So, you know, sometimes I use sugar, sometimes I use this condensed milk. So it's absolutely upon your choice. So add it into our halwa. Okay. Add as per you want sweetness in your halwa. So first of all, I'm going to add like a bit more than a half of the condensed milk, and then I will, you know, judge the taste. And if I want to have more sweetness, then I will going to add. So now at this point, keep your flame little bit on a like high, on a medium. You need to be like a bit patient with this halwa if you want to have a like authentic traditional taste. And definitely you have to keep stir it in between like after 5 to 7 minutes. So, you know, you don't have to keep stirring it constantly. So that's a good point. So now mix everything well. Okay, some of the halwa stick to bottom, so mix that too. And now our condensed milk is properly mixed with our halwa. So at this point, I'm going to taste it. It is still need to be added. So now I'm going to add this all to it. So for 2 lb, we'll need one tin of condensed milk. Okay. Now at the same point, I want to add my all the nuts. This is my raisin. This is a sliced almond and cashew nuts. So I'm going to add this. Going to save a little bit for garnishing, and remaining I'm going to add now. Okay. That's it. And now mix everything well. And now for the final touch, we have to cook it between like medium to high flame for next 10 minutes. And we have to burn all this moisture. So now at this point, you have to, you know, keep stirring it. Because see, if you will going to cook it on a low flame, it will take more time. And as we already added this condensed milk, now it can, you know, like stick to bottom. So that's why we have to keep stirring it. And we have to cook it fast. Okay guys, so it's more been like 7 to 8 minutes, and now as you can see that our moisture of condensed milk and our remaining milk is totally evaporated. Now we want that much of consistency of our halwa. So now at this point, our halwa is done. Approximately this halwa will take you like approximately 1 hour to cook. But this is the most, you know, delicious dessert I can ever rank in my Indian dessert and sweet section. Okay, so now I'm going to off my stove. So now it's been like around 20-30 minutes, and like my halwa is like warm, it's not hot right now. So now the last ingredients which I'm going to use is crushed nutmeg powder, and freshly crushed nutmeg powder, and cardamom powder. So if you like this spices, You can definitely add it. I just love it, you know. So I always use this in my almost all Indian sweets. So yeah, that's it. And now I don't know you can see it or not, but here, you know, this is little tiny tweeny drops, like bubbles, and these are called khoya, which is automatically generated because we have added 4 cups of milk, and then after, you know, we cook it for like half an hour, so that milk convert into the khoya. Now you can even use a half an hour, but it will be so rich. And except you can even, you know, instead of 4 cup, you can add like 5 or 6 cup of milk. So, you know, it will take some more time to burn, but it will create some more khoya. So that natural khoya will give superb taste to your halwa. So that was the tip. You can, you know, like create a naturally khoya into your halwa. You don't need to add a special khoya. You don't have to buy and, you know, add it in your halwa. So now I'm going to mix it. And you know what, I couldn't wait myself, so when it was hot, I already have like one small bowl of it, and that is delicious. It's heavenly delicious, you know. I just love Gajar Halwa, so even though it doesn't matter how it's turned out, I will always going to love it. So anyway, now at this point our halwa is ready. You can have this halwa either hot or either cold, both the way it will taste perfect. So definitely it's upon your preference that how you want to eat. And now at this point we are done. So keep this in the refrigerator, you know, because we have added milk into it, so definitely you have to keep it into refrigerator. Hey friends, so yeah, that's it. Now for this and many more recipes, visit my site at www.georgecrazyforveggie.com for detailed ingredients and printable recipe. Now hope you guys like my this recipe of making how to make Gajar Halwa. This is quite easy but little time consuming, but anyway, I can do anything for taste. So hope you guys enjoy. See you next time with my another recipe. Till then, cheeky. Goodbye.